Welcome back to New Day Cleveland, and welcome Joe Rosalina from Russo, Rosalina & Company, a law firm, right?
Here in Cleveland.
And here's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about things that people should already have done, perhaps, or they could plan and start doing it right now, because we're talking about like wills, living wills, talking about probate. You lose somebody in your family, you learn about that the hard way. So how do people prepare their, set their life up so they don't have problems?
Well, we got a general practice, so we see a ton of people that come in and they just need some basic documents. So we usually tell people there's at least four basic documents you should always have. You should have a will.
How often should you change that will?
Well, it depends on your needs and your goals. If you know, a lot of people will change their will if they have children.
Little kids growing up.
Get married, exactly. So they'll want to change maybe who the executor is. But you should do a will just so you know who you're leaving your assets to. You make it clear. You don't want to let the state of Ohio determine where your assets are going to go.
Who takes care of your kids if something happens to you?
You can appoint and nominate a guardian in your will in the event that you should predecease your spouse. Your spouse dies and then your children are still minors, you can name a guardian. So you can do that in a will as well. But basically, to make it clear where you want your assets to go is why you're going to do a will. So you should have a will. You should have a living will.
What's the difference between a will and a living will?
A will is the last will and testament is where you leave all of your assets to whomever you choose. A living will is just a document that tells the doctors and hospitals that in the event you're in a terminal condition, that you don't want to be put on life support.
So that's a decision that you've made for yourself, and other people just bring out that instrument.
Correct.
And then it's done the way you want it to be done.
Right. A lot of people give it to their doctor or put it at the hospital so it's on record. And then you've got a healthcare power of attorney and a financial power of attorney. The healthcare power of attorney is where you would appoint somebody to make decisions for you in the event you can't make them. So if you get to a point in your life where you just can't make decisions for yourself or manage your own affairs, there's somebody in place to do that. It avoids the need for a guardianship later on down the road. So parents become elderly, they can't take care of themselves, mm-hmm. whether they're mentally incompetent or they just can't handle their own affairs. If they can't competently make a legal decision, then a guardian needs to be appointed, and that's a lengthy, costly, burdensome process that you can avoid by just making sure that you've got the proper directives in place beforehand.
Plus, you make sure that the right person who can handle a job like that can help take care of you rather than the wrong person.
Exactly. You want to be able to make that choice because maybe my son can do it. I want to make sure that my son is the power of attorney in place.
So it's pretty simple to figure out. The health one is for health, and then the financial one is making sure your assets are being handled the right way.
Sure. So if you need somebody to open and close bank accounts or write checks for you, sell stock, anything you need to
pay your bills while you might be in the hospital.
Absolutely. That's what the power of attorney is going to do.
Okay, so you know you need all these things. I just learned about two I don't have.
Okay.
So I go to your office, I call your office. People are intimidated about what a lawyer might cost.
Mm-hmm.
How easy is this for people to do and how costly is it?
So somebody comes, if you call the office, you schedule an appointment, you come in to see me tomorrow, those four documents, I might spend 10 minutes getting some information from you. You come back a week from that day. So a week from Wednesday, you'd come back and see me, you'd be there 10, 15 minutes. You need to read over the documents, make sure it's all what you want, mm-hmm. it's everything's spelled correctly. You sign everything, we're gonna take care of witnessing, notarizing everything. We store some of the original documents in our office.
So that way you know where the backups are.
You know where the will is. For example, we store original wills in our vault, give you copies to take home. So that takes about a week for us to prepare. We almost look at it like a public service. Everybody mm-hmm. should have a will. So
right.
This will probably floor you because I can guarantee you that nobody does basic estate planning documents for the price of $30 for a will, $25 for a healthcare power of attorney, $75 for a financial, and $25 for a living will.
So like around 150 bucks or so, you can wrap up the most important factors in your life now and after.
You and your wife should have all of those documents. You should also have a survivorship deed on your home. Mm-hmm. If you own a home, you should have the property titled so that in the event something happens to one of you, that interest then can pass to the other, to the surviving spouse, without having to do too much work. As a spouse, it's a lot easier. So if you spend anywhere from $300 to $500, you'd wrap up your entire basic estate plan.
Okay.
And that's pretty reasonable.
Joe Rosalina, next time you come on, and please come on again, we've got to talk about like probate for people who have messed up, they don't have the right documents in place, how to straighten that mess out.
Come see us. We do about 225 estates a year. We do a ton of probate work.
Thank you very much.
All right, Dave, thank you.
How about some more New Day Cleveland after this?
That'd be great.